Here's some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of NVIDIA following its weak guidance. Shares of the AI darling slumped 3% in pre-market trading. Also in focus, shares of French semiconductor materials firm Soitec after the company delivered a reassuring set of first-half fiscal 2025 results and reiterated its full-year guidance. Soitec shares jumped nearly 12% on the news. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of JD Sports after it warned that its annual profit would come in at the lower end of its guidance. Shares of the British retailer fell 15.5% in midday trade.
Asian markets ended Thursday trade lower as tech stocks in the region fell after NVIDIA's forecast. Japan's Nikkei 225 slid 0.8%, while the Hong Kong Hang Seng closed down 0.5%. The local bourse joining the region-wide slump just a day after posting its biggest single-day climb in nearly 2 years.
Investors have taken profits from the market's four-day previous rally. At the same time, I believe investors are digesting certain factors. Number one would be the depreciation of the local currency. At the same time, investors also dealing with escalation of tensions between Russia and Ukraine. And finally, if you're going to notice, the local market pulled back at a time when it was nearing the 7,000 resistance level, which goes to show that the market is not yet prepared to take the said resistance, which could mean that investors are waiting for further catalyst before moving forward.
Also in the spotlight, India's benchmark indices, which slumped after a drag from the Adani Group company stocks. That's after U.S. authorities indicted their chairman, Gautam Adani, over his role in a $265 million bribery scheme involving his renewable energy arm. The flagship firm Adani Enterprises plunged over 23%, its worst one-day drop since February 2023, while Adani Green Energy, the company in the middle of all of it, tumbled 19%. Other Adani stocks also fell between 7 and 19%, shaving off as much as $27 billion in market value for the group. In a statement, the Adani Group called the charges baseless, adding it will seek all possible legal recourse.
The Philippine peso sinks to an over two-year low against the U.S. dollar. The local currency closed at 15.9 to the dollar level Thursday, its weakest since October 2022. The greenback has been on the rise since the re-election of Donald Trump, amid anticipation potential tariffs from his administration will likely be inflationary and keep rates higher for longer.
The weakness of the peso wasn't just the weakness of the peso. I think we've seen it for all emerging market currencies. Mm. It was probably more the strength of the U.S. dollar following the Trump presidency. Mm. Markets were trading into the U.S. dollar quite heavily, thinking that rates would be more sustained, more elevated, considering the inflationary measures that he might impose in the near term. So I guess that's what's keeping the peso weak. You're right. We should see a seasonally strong period.
Philippine Central Bank Governor Eli Remolona, meanwhile, says he is not worried about the peso slide.
Yeah, we don't worry so much about whether the peso depreciates or appreciates. We worry about the pass-through effect. Pero ngayon medyo okay po naman. Depreciates very sharply, then we talk. Kung hindi naman sharp, it doesn't become inflationary. It's inflationary kung medyo sharp. At saka tuloy-tuloy. Hindi kami nakikialam doon sa day-to-day movements. Binabantayan namin yung swings that take place over a few months in the araw-araw.